Our third candidate for U.S. Senate to address the convention will be Mr. Clint Didier. Mr. Didier is a former pro football player, twice Super Bowl champion, a very successful farmer and businessman, and high school football coach. Please join me in welcoming Mr. Clint Didier.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you and good morning, and thank you for making last night's tailgate party a great success. We the people. The first three words of the most powerful document of this great land, our Constitution, that gives the power to the people. By God, it's time we, the people, had the courage and the fortitude to take our country back. And I see a whole room here of my fellow Americans here in defiance of tyranny. My name is Clint Didier, and I'm running for the U.S. Senate. And I have a game plan. Government accountability to we, the people. Military, national security, that means secure our borders. And economic prosperity. That means unshackle our industries and get rid of the regulation and let them run again. Now, yesterday I had my whole day planned out, and then Sarah called. So I jumped in a plane, I went and met with Sarah, and what a great day it was. A woman of grit that radiates positive. Positive. The positive attitude we gotta have to get this country back. Yes, I do come from Eastern Washington, from a little town called Eltopia that was once called Hell to Pay. Because when they laid the railroad ties and the irons, it was 117 degrees. And the railroad workers said they had to go through hell to get their paycheck. Well, let me tell you what, when I get to D.C., there's going to be hell to pay, and I'm taking the heat back with me. Thank you. It was there that I learned the qualities of success from my parents, and not through words, but by example. Desire, hard work, dedication, persistence, determination. These were the qualities that made America great. These are the qualities that are making America great again. They brought me back to the farm, where I coached high school football, and I instilled those same qualities in the young men, our future leaders, and we just won a state championship last year. The one of the hardest things to do was to tell those young men I wasn't going to coach them again. But I told them what I'm going to do now is far more important than coaching. I'm going back to fight for their liberty and their freedom, to make sure they have that same shot at the American dream that I and every one of you have had. Now, some people may say, well, he's just a football jock. But for 8 years, ladies and gentlemen, the establishment had the football. We lost yardage. Our backs are against the goal line. We're in the fourth quarter, and time's running out. It's time to put the offense back on the field and move this field that direction to the other goal line and score. Thank you. Yeah, America is upside down. We're in a world of hurt. And quite frankly, I think we're headed straight for hell. How are we going to take this country back? You and I and all the organizations uniting, creating one force in one direction, and fighting our way back to the light, to the truth, to the Constitution, and to the Lord God Almighty. That's how we're going to get our country back. George Washington said, I hope and trust we have good sense and virtue enough left to recover the right path. Charlton Heston said, the American dream isn't success or riches, it's freedom. Freedom. Freedom brings liberty, and freedom, liberty brings success. One of my favorite shows is Braveheart. When William Wallace was a lad and his dad was laying on that rock, that slab rock, that cold slab rock, and he was killed in war trying to get their freedom. And he dreamed that night after he touched his dad and he was cold. And he dreamed that night he seen his dad again. He rolled his head over and he says, your heart is free if you have the courage to follow it. Follow it. And may God save these United States of America. Thank you.